The woman on the run in your script, she's about to have her throat slit. And you have her pleading with him. If she reacted like you just did, that would be realistic. I just wanted to show you some real. Sorry for the scare.
Jonathan Rhys-Meyers plays a drifter who engages in a battle of wits with a desperate writer played by Antonio Banderas in Black Butterfly.
Well, Jonathan is with us. So this is a light romantic comedy. It looks good. Do you always play the dark character, the bad guy? This drifter, we don't know if he's good or bad just yet.
The purpose of the story is for you to be confused as much as possible as to what this guy is. But yeah, he's a drifter, you know, he's, you know, a vagrant, he's all of these things. He's presented as this loner who, you know, he travels the roads, you know, hoping to sort of like pick up mm-hmm. victims along the way. He chooses Antonio Banderas' victim because he's a man who's in a desperate situation. And of course, people who prey on those type of victims can recognize it. It's very, very evident to them. And so, you know, Antonio's character invites me back to his remote house. He's a writer trying to complete a novel. And this young man tries to influence him. And what happens is a type of Stockholm syndrome.
Oh.
Where they start playing this very intricate, complex, and dangerous game with each other.
Where does Black Butterfly, I'm trying to understand the meaning of the title. Is it sort of your character or is it Antonio's character?
Well, the Papillon Noir.
Oh.
It's originally from a French movie, and the Papillon Noir is always seen as an omen of change, whether it's an omen of change for positivity or it's an omen of change for negativity.
Huh.
It's metaphorical. You know how deep. the French get. Oh.
It's very deep. How do you say deep in French?
Deep.
Deep.
Deep. Deep Pepin Le Pew. Are there any light moments, like when they say cut, did you Antonio crack up or have this? I still think of him as Puss in Boots. I go right back no matter what role he plays.
The big eyes. You want the big eyes.
I want to go into that voice. So tell me any light moments in between takes.
Well, you know, there always is. I mean, as actors, you're making a production, yeah. So obviously it's a serious business. But of course, there's laughing and there's joking. I mean, Antonio, I'd never met Antonio before we did this, but of course, I'd seen him in many, many movies. I grew up with his films as a teenager.
Yeah.
And every so often, you work with people. Some people you work with and you like very, very much, and some people you work with because you have to work with. Antonio he's just a beautiful man. You know, obviously.
Oh, he is. We know he's a beautiful man.
Okay, ladies, obviously we know he's a beautiful man. But he's a beautiful man for other men also.
Yes.
He's kind, he's generous, he's intelligent, he's multilingual.
Mm-hmm.
He's a movie star, he's rich, he plays music, he's from Spain. I mean, really, he's kind
he's
of...
beautiful.
He's ticking a few boxes.
I always think of him on Saturday Night Live when he hosted and he did he walks in and the shirt opens up like a soap opera star.
He's so fun.
Great. But did you guys hang out after you guys were shooting? Did you have drinks, some you know, let the sangria flow?
Well, we went to a party the first night I arrived there. It was very, very beautiful. We arrived in Rome and we stayed in this beautiful house in Piazza del Popolo. And I used to live in Rome. I lived in Rome when
oh
I was
my
a young
gosh.
Man. So it was so beautiful to go back to a city that was once a home to me. So
yeah.
it was really nice. Working with the Italians was wonderful. But, you know, myself and Antonio, we work hard. So
yeah.
When we finish our 12-hour day, I think we kind of get a little bored with each other and then go home.
Yeah, well, you got a baby to go home to now. We saw a little
Well, my
wolf,
wife was
right?
pregnant while we were
okay.
doing the job.
Yeah.
So I didn't quite have a baby to go home to, but I had my wife to go home to and she needed attention.
Aww.
So.
Well, sit tight right there, Jonathan. We were in the hallway, so I saw
Aww,
a little wolf
look
go
at this
by.
Picture.
But we're going to talk about being a new dad and how it all has changed you. Much more with Jonathan coming up next. We're back with Jonathan Rhys-Meyers, who stars with Antonio Banderas, the new thriller Black Butterfly, which looks like quite the thriller there. But on a side note, tell us about being a dad for the first time.
It's indescribable. Of course, I was nervous. I'm a father for the first time. So for about a month before the baby was born, of course, all the emotions start flooding up. How is this going to be? But he's an angel. He's an angel boy. He's got a very sort of like deep, intense nature towards him.
So I wonder where he gets it.
What's that?
So I wonder where he gets it.
Oh no, he's his mama's boy. Thank goodness he's his mama's boy. But yeah, he's got a beautiful intensity. He stares right into your soul. Aww. He's got a very, very sweet nature. He's very calm. He sleeps right through the night, which is extraordinary for a new baby. He's the joy of my life. I mean, it is. People say that, you know, when you have children, it changes you.
Yeah.
And of course, it does change you. But I just didn't know the profundity of the change that was going to take place.
Well, I see you get emotional as you just started describing your son.
Yeah, well, it's not even emotional. Is that every single thing that you desired, all of your aspirations, all of your goals, all of these little peccadilloes that you have to make sure that you get what you want in life, pale in comparison to what this little boy needs.
Aww.
And so, you know, everybody goes through their days where they have incredibly positive moments and they go have a few negative moments. And these negative moments become less and less and less and less and less with the boy, because the boy needs that attention. He needs your warmth. He needs your kindness. And and he has it in spades, you know. And I have a wonderful wife. So, you know, how could I be any luckier?
What were you worried about in the beginning when she was pregnant before he came out? What were your concerns?
Well, we have this living thing, you know. Suddenly this Cabbage Patch Kid has come to life. and so with demands and nappy changes and all that, which it's funnily enough, you know.
Are you doing that? The nappy changes?
I love that. That's the easiest part of it.
Yeah.
The nappy changes, the feeding. This is all the easy stuff. The hard stuff is that before I had the child, I had very, very little fear of things. You know, and since I've had my child, I can't read newspaper stories about sort of things that are happening to children. I can't watch the news with things that are happening. I get very, very angry. So I think a new sort of positive fear has replaced the sort of egotistical, I'm an actor fear. Now, I like being an actor. I like Hollywood, but I love my son.
Yeah.
And there's a difference. It's that sort of agape. It's, you know, unconditional. It's the most beautiful thing in the world.
Oh. Wow, I love that. Well, you've moved us. Black Butterfly is in theaters right now.
And we're going to go backstage and kiss and hug Little Wolf.
Yeah.
Is that okay with you?
Oh, absolutely.
I can't wait.
It takes a village to raise a
child. It does.